Hi friends, in this video we'll discuss about the Python polymorphism concept. The last videos we done the inheritance concept, right? I think 22 and 23 classes. In this video we'll discuss 24th class here. Go to the file menu, click on new. Others, go to the Python here. This is a video class number 24, right? Good. So we'll discuss about the polymorphism here. So polymorphism, got it. Tell me, what do you mean polymorphism? So as you know, so in other languages you have the polymorphism concept, right? One functionality with the different behaviors. So one functionality, it exists multiple behavior, right? It's showing multiple behaviors. One functionality with different behaviors is called polymorphism, right? So we can say multiple definition here. The definition number one functionality with the different behaviors is called polymorphism. Otherwise, one more point here, the ability to appear in more than one form is called polymorphism. The ability to appear in more than one form is called polymorphism, right? That's it. So if you take the sleep method, sleep is a method, so sleep is a function, it is having 1000 milliseconds. Like that, in other languages and any other language. So sleep is 1 milliseconds, like that. If you take the same sleep method, 1000 milliseconds and 2000 nanoseconds. Sleep is how many functionalities here? One functionality. But how many behaviors is there? Two behaviors, right? That is called polymorphism concept here. If you take the sum method with one argument. So if you take the same sum method with two arguments, so integer A, integer B, right? So one functionality showing different behaviors, this concept is called which concept here? Polymorphism. Assume here, without polymorphism, there is no polymorphism. There is no polymorphism means, for this functionality we have to take one method, for this functionality we have to take another method or not. What do you mean polymorphism? One functionality with the different behaviors. Best example is a sleep, sum, weight, like the number of methods are there. In Python, we'll discuss about the overriding here. So overriding to show the complete polymorphism concept. What do you mean overriding? Tell me here. Whenever the faculty said overriding, immediately you have to think, that implementation is already present in the parent class. But as a child, we are not satisfied with the parent implementation. For example, for the marriage purpose, my father is finding one girl. But that girl is very black girl. Tell me, as a child, I'm satisfied with black girl or not? Like, I'm not interested to marry black girl, right? Then you can take the child class. As a child class, I'm overriding the same method to write my own implementation. That is called overriding concept. See, for example, declare the class parent here. So assume it contains def marriage method. So some implementations, which one here? Some black girl is there. What about child situation here? How to declare the child class? Class child with extension of which class here? Parent class, right? So, but I'm not satisfied with the black girl. Let me override that method to write my own implementation. Red girl, right? This is called overriding concept. Now here you can check it. The parent class marriage method contains one implementation. The child class marriage contains some other implementation, right? Then how many functionalities here? Only one functionality. Marriage is one functionality only, right? But how many behaviors we have? Multiple behaviors or not? That is called polymorphism concept. We have one functionality with different behaviors. Otherwise, the ability to appear in more than one form is called polymorphism. Whenever the faculty said overriding concept, implementation is already present with the parent class, but I don't want my father implementation. I want to write my own implementation. Then you can override to write your own implementation. Right? That's it. Let me do some practicals here. We get some clarity. Example one. So in front of the video, don't sit ideal. Can please take the pen and paper. Can please write all the points here. So video class number 23, I think. 20 to 24, I think. Good. 24. Clear? Good. Example one. Go to example one. To write some practicals, go to the file menu. Click on new. Others. We can select the simply Python here. Click on OK. So I'm taking overriding variable in this example. But the example one here, overriding variable here. Okay, overriding variable means assume class parent is there. Parent contains name is Ratan. Okay, you can take the class child child extends which class your parent. Within the parenthesis you can take the parent, right? Then you can take the name equal to 1. The parent class contains name Ratan, right? But in the child class I'm declaring same name. It means my own implementations. So no, it means my own implementation, right? That's it. Let me create the object of child class. Create the object of child class. Python is all about the indentation here. Alignment we have to check. Then call the c dot. Let me write the print message. Print of. Simply can call c dot name. C dot name is which name is printed here. Let me save this application. Control S. For the application name I will save always first dot python file. FIREST first dot python file. So let me do the execution of this file. To do the execution, just open the command prompt. So where is your file here? In local disk E, right? Move to the local disk E. In the local disk E, what is the file here? Python. The file is called first.python file. On is printed, right? Because we are overriding. So for example, I'm not overriding. Let me declare the pass. Pass means there is no implementation, right? In the child class, I don't have any implementation. It means I'm satisfied with my father implementation. Then simply can run this code. You will get the Ratan, right? So that's it. This is called which concept here? Overriding concept. Oh yes, sir. No, this is overriding, right? Good. But the first case here, the first case, if we are overriding, so then which class? Yeah? Then our class variable executed or not. What is the second case? Yeah? So if we are not overriding, then which class? Parent class variable executed, right? That's it. So if you are overriding, then child class will get the anu's output. If you are not overriding, then parent class variable executed, right? Sir, no, that's all. We clearly am explaining point by point. Can you please take the notes? And can you please take the example? Can you please prepare the notes here? Because I'm uploading all the videos, right? Just check the all the videos one by one. You can write the notes, write the notes clearly. And pass the information to your friends. Ratan sir is taking Python class test. You can check it once. This is overriding which one here? Variables. And example 2, we'll discuss about the overriding methods. Overriding methods, right? Good. So coming to the overriding methods, the same example. Declare the class basing class keyword, class parent class. The parent class contains def marriage method. To represent this method is belongs to class self keyword. My father is finding one girl here for the marriage. That girl is, I said, what? Black girl, right? Sir, no, simply can say black girl. That's it. Well, sir, no, black girl. What about child situation here? Class child. Child extends which class here? The parent class, right? Good. But tell me here, I'm satisfied with my parent implementation or not? I'm satisfied with the parent implementations or not? No, right? If I'm not satisfied with the parent implementation, can you please declare the same method? What def marriage method with a self argument? Yes or no? Self argument. And here you can write my own implementation. What a girl here? Red girl, right? That's it. This is called overriding. So marriage implementation already present with my father. But I said, father, I don't want black girl. I want my own implementation. If you want your own implementation, just you can override to write your own implementation, right? Good. Then simply create the object of which class here? Child class. C equal to simply can write the child of. C equal child of. Then you can call the simply C dot which method here? Marriage method, right? That's it. Then tell me, C dot marriage means which class method? Parent class method or child class method? Child class, right? Because you're overriding. Right? Assume Ratan sir, I'm not overriding. Declare the pass. Pass means empty data. No data here. No data means don't remove this. Don't remove it like this. You will get error message. So you have to represent. Here there is no data. Simply can go with the pass. You have to represent here there is no data, right? Then you have to go with the pass, right? That's it. Simply now we can run this code. You will get the black girl, right? Because I am not overriding. If I am not overriding, then what happened? My father implementations will be executed, right? If I am not overriding, then what happened here? My father implementations executed or not? That's it. Okay, clear? That's all, guys. So this is example 2. So what are the first case here? Red girl is executing. Red girl means we are overriding or not overriding? We are overriding, right? Good. So if you are overriding the override method, then our class method executed, right? That's it. Whatever next one here. So if we are not overriding, then which one here? Parent class method executed or not? Clear? That's it, guys. While writing, if in case spell mistakes are there, don't write the comment here. One guy's written the comment, Ratan sir, inheritance spelling is wrong. Feeling important, right? Yes, sir, no, yeah. Feeling important. While typing, maybe mistakes. Leave it. First example, we are overriding variables. Next example, we are overriding the methods. We're clear, huh? So what do you mean overriding? So implementation is already present in the parent, but I don't want my parent implementation. I can override to write my own implementation, right? Wait, to write my own implementations. Sir, that's all. So this is all about the two examples regarding overriding. If you want, I'll give one more example here. Example 3. Coming to the example 3, see, always, it is showing the polymorphism here. One functionality with different behaviors are not. Marriage the functionality with black girl. Marriage the functionality with red girl. One functionality showing multiple behaviors, right? Polymorphism is a Greek word here. Poly means many, morphism means forms, polymorphism means many forms, right? Sir, no, yeah, that's it. So if you want, I'll write one more example regarding polymorphism. You can check it. I can take the class parrot class. What about parrot? Parrot can fly, right? So def, you can take the fly method. To represent this message belongs to class self keyword. Simply can write the message printer. So parrot so can fly, right? So parrot can fly. So def, you can write the swim method. To represent this message belongs to class self keyword, you can write the print message. So print off, so parrot, tell me, parrot can swim or not? So cannot swim, right? We parrot cannot swim. This is my parent implementation, sir. Okay, I can take one more class. Class, we can take the penguin. So you can write the penguin. Penguin, right? Class penguin. This separate class, a different class. Class penguin. If you take the def, so you can take the fly. So penguin can fly or not? No, right? Simply can write the print message, fly method. Tell me here. So penguin can fly or not? Yeah, cannot, right? So cannot fly. So you can take one more method, def swim method, right? But penguin can swim or not? Swim here. To represent this method is belongs to class self keyword. Here also to represent this method is belongs to class self keyword. Simply can write the print message. So simply can write the print off. Tell me, print off. So here to represent this, sorry, good, print off. Here you can write the message. What message? Yeah? So penguin. Wait, tell me. So penguin. So can swim, right? Penguin can swim. That's it. Here I taken the two different classes, parrot class and penguin class. Different class has a different own implementations, right? Fly is only one functionality, but how many behaviors? Two behaviors are there. At runtime, which object you are passing, that behavior will be executed or not. Always showing the functionality in different forms. Sir, that's it. Let me take one common interface. Common interface to pass the data. Common interface. Def, I'm taking one function. So what are the function I'm taking here? So flying under flying test here. Flying test, it is expecting some object. So you can pass the board object, some object name, right? But just like this is also variable here, just variable. Expecting one variable, right? That's it. Based on the bird here, reference variable, bird, we can call the which method here? Fly method. I'm checking the flying test, right? Fly method. Yes, sir, no, yeah. I'm calling the fly, right? That's it. I'm taking one common interface. I'm taking the flying test is a common function. That function is having the argument is called some argument, bird argument. Once you are passing that argument, with that argument, I can call the fly function. fly method. Observe carefully. Let me create the objects here. So create the objects. Create the objects of which class here? Penguin and parrot. P equal to parrot here. Next one is what? So parrot, right? Simply can write the PA. So penguin, PN, some penguin here. Otherwise PN, that's it. So penguin, right? That's it. I'm taking two objects, right? That's all. So here, based on these objects here, I'm passing the objects to, but my common interface. Simply next one is what? Passing the objects or not? Project level, the project level, the coding is done like this. We don't think what is this example. Project level, always the coding is done like this actually. So parrot class, penguin class, we can take the, we have the common interface. For that interface, which object we are passing, at runtime, that fly method will be executed. To pass that bird object, I am creating two objects, parrot and penguin object. I am calling the method. How do you call the method here? Flying underscore test class of, here I am passing parrot object here. Parrot, here I am passing which object here? PA, because this is nothing but PA, right? Then bird dot fly means, we are passing which object here? Parrot object or not? Parrot object means, parrot can fly or not? Yes, parrot can fly. Wait, parrot can fly. Saying error message, what error message here? Simply can say flying. FLY. Good. So you can read the message. Parrot can fly, right? That's it. Otherwise, same thing you can call by using penguin also. So penguin here, you can pass the bird object. P and penguin. So this penguin is stored in the bird object or not. Just this is reference variable here. I hope you'll get the clarity, right? Yes or no? Good. Simply can run the code. Penguin cannot fly, right? At runtime, which bird we are passing, that implementations will be executed, right? Because fly is having one implementations or different implementations here. Different implementations, right? At runtime, which object we are passing, that implementations will be executed. Yes or no? That's all. Any doubts regarding this example? Example 3. So like that, here you can take the flying test, right? Swim test also you can take, no problem. And this example you can call by using swim test also, yeah. Swim test also, no problem. See, for example here, SWIM swim is there. Here spelling mistake is there, yeah. SWIM swim is there, right? Good. Here you can take the data SWIM swim test here. We can call which method here? Swim method here. Swimming here. Here simply you can write the swim test. SWIM swim test, right? That's it. Previously I taken the example regarding which one here? Flying test, right? Flying test, which bird we are passing, that bird fly may be executed. Like which data we are passing. If you are passing parrot object, then parrot fly executed. If you are passing penguin object, then penguin fly will be executed, right? Yes or no? That's all. Now we are passing swimming object, right? Swim object. Now what is the message we will get here? Parrot cannot swim, penguin can swim, right? Like that. I hope you'll get some clarity, right? At runtime, which object you are passing, that method will be executed or not. Small observation. Previous example, this example is clear. Previously I'm taking flying test, now I'm taking swim test, right? Sir, no, yeah. That's all. But sir, give me one more example. Example 4. Same example here. Same example I can take. Same type of example. I'm taking one class unicorn bike and splendor bike. At runtime, which object you are passing, that object speed will be executed, right? I'll give the points. Try to complete this example here. Can please take the class splendor class. Sorry, class unicorn bike. Ratan sir bike is unicorn here. Ratan sir like unicorn. Class unicorn bike and a class, second class is what? Splendor bike, right? Splendor bike. Two bikes are there. This is having the speed here. This is also having the speed method. So now speed method and speed method, right? Two methods are there. Speed and speed is there. So now you can take one common interface. So def some speed test. Why speed test? You can take some common interface. For that common interface, you can call the speed. call which method here, here speed. Create the object of create the previous, just like previous example here, create the objects of unicorn and splendor. Okay, so pass the data. Once you are passing the unicorn data, then unicorn speed will be executed. If you are passing the splendor data, means splendor data will be executed, right? Okay, so based on my explanation, can please start the example here. I'm repeating once again, you can check it. Take the unicorn, taking the speed here, take the splendor, take the speed method. Speed method is having some implementation, 150 kmph. Sir, no, yeah, good. So like that you can take some data, like that you can take some data, right? They are activating Windows. Good, good. Wait, clear, huh? That's all, guys. So here I'm taking two classes, eh? Class unicorn class, class splendor class. Splendor class contains speed method. Unicorn also contains speed method here. Unicorn also contains what? Speed method, right? Sir, no, that's it. Can please try to complete this example here for this one here. Kilometer per, just you can write some message, kilometer per hour here, kilometer per hour, right? Can take the speed test class here, the speed test, then create the object for that one, pass the data. Which object you are passing, that method will be executed, right? That's all, guys. Clear? Good. Tell me the code for that one here. Take the class, which class here? We class unicorn, right? Class unicorn, def, which function you have to take, speed method. To represent this method, it belongs to class self. Class self, the print message, simply can write the message here. So unicorn speed, unicorn the speed, unicorn speed 150, so kmph, right? Kilometer per hour, that's it. So message you can write. Next one is what? Class. What the class here? You can take the splendor class, right? So class splendor class, separate classes, both are separate classes. Class splendor class, so no, class splendor. Good. Here also you can take the def, you can take the speed here. To represent this is belongs to class self, simply can add the print message, print, so splendor speed, so I hand in the 100, so kmph, right? Some message I'll write, that's it. Then you can take the common interface, common data. What the common data here? Tell me, so common data. What the common data here? I'm taking def. Simply can write the speed test, right? You can take the speed, speed underscore test, speed test. Is expecting some SP speed, some reference variable, right? Based on the SP, we can call the speed here. Okay. So then we have to create the object, right? Create the object, sir. Tell me how to create the object here. U equal to unicorn of, tell me, U equal to unicorn of, S equal to splendor, right? Splendor of. Then last one is what? Simply pass the objects. Which objects you are passing, that speed will be executed, right? To pass the object, speed underscore test of, here I am passing unicorn. Then what happened here? This is a reference variable, right? This unicorn we are passing here. This variable no need to be same here. You can passing unicorn object means SP is nothing but unicorn object now. Now you are calling SP dot speed means then which speed execute here? Unicorn speed execute or not? That's all, guys. So you can take the speed of, speed underscore test, speed test of, you are passing splendor, right? You are passing splendor means the splendor data will be executed, right? Splendor speed 100 kmph, right? That's it, guys. That's it, guys. This is all about your concept here, polymorphism concept. Clear? Any doubts regarding these points here? We done the four examples clearly. So check these all the examples here. We'll get some clarity regarding our polymorphism concept, right? That's all. Showing one functionality with a different behavior, sir, is called polymorphism concept. I'll repeat all the examples and you can check it out. We're discussing video class number 24, polymorphism concept. So what do you mean polymorphism here? One functionality with different behaviors. Sleep is a function, you have the two different behaviors. Sum is a function, you have the two different behaviors, right? This is called which concept? Polymorphism concept. One functionality showing the multiple behaviors. otherwise the ability to appears in more than one form. So no, the best example is you guys only. In the classroom, one behavior, outside one behavior, with X one behavior, with Y one behavior, at home one behavior, right? Like one person different behaviors here. That is called polymorphism concept. My father is fine. Whenever the faculty said overriding concept, whenever the faculty said overriding, discussing overriding, immediately how to think, implementation is already there with the parent. But I don't want parent implementation. I can override to write my own implementation, right? Implementation is already present with the parent, but I don't want parent implementation. I can override in child class to write my own implementations, right? That's all. The first example we done with overriding variable. If you are overriding, then our class variable executed. If you are not overriding, then parent class. Next one is what? Overriding methods. If you are overriding, then our class method executed, the red girl. If I am not overriding, my father implementation, black, right? So no, then parrot. Parrot and penguin. You can take the common interface, can create the object. At runtime, which object you are passing for this one, that method will be executed. This is flying test. If you want, you can take the swim test also. Which one you want, you can apply. Then unicorn, splendor, speed test, create the object and pass the data, right? Unicorn, one method is there. Splendor is also one method is there. Speed test I'm calling. For the speed test is a common data. For this common data, which object we are passing at runtime, which object you are passing, that implementation executed, right? Because speed is having one implementations or different implementations. Why is speed is having one implementations or different implementations here? Different implementations, right? That's the reason. Way clear? That's all, guys. That's all the polymorphism concept. So check the videos here. Don't waste the time. I'm uploading all the videos. I've been almost all 24 videos are done. Take all the points, notes clearly. We can check my notes with anyone. Our notes is perfect. We'll do more practical. Theory points, while explanation, you can take some theory points. But more about the practicals, right? More about the practicals. So thank you guys, thanks for watching. Okay, please like the video and comment the video. And share the videos here. And subscribe to our channel to get the more updates. Thank you guys, bye.